Welcome back to Red Dragon Inn, Battle for Greyport. Up first in this turn will be Gurky. And one thing I should mention, I had said I would tell you about these abilities on Drog, the Troll General. Later on when they became important, actually Vengeful is important because if we attacked any creature that is attacking the location, he would then come towards the active player. It hasn't happened, so we haven't had to worry about it. Ferocious means he will always be with the active player, or the defending player, once he leaves a location. And Slash 1 means if he deals damage to any the defending player, the other player is also going to get 1 damage. So that's his abilities in a nutshell. Okay, up first, Gurky. Unfortunately, he had that Orc Warlord last time, so he couldn't draw any cards. So he's only left with 1 card, and that's the Assassin. So, you know, he's going to play the Assassin. And because of the location Red Dragon Inn, defending player has +1 hero. Well, he doesn't have any. So there's nothing much he can really do. So let's take a look at Deirdre and see what she's going to play. Now, I want to keep her shields for her turn. She only has 2 hit points left. Gurky here has 5. So Gurky can take a bunch more damage. So I think we're just going to have... I don't know. I think we're just going to have Deirdre play the soldier with the short sword. I think she's going to save the rest for her turn. So that's going to be soldier, short sword, 2 damage to 1 creature. So that is basically playing a hero and playing 1 item on a hero. Now it is time for Gurky to go. Now the location has 4 hit points left. It's going to take 3 damage this turn, so it's not going to be destroyed this turn, but it will be destroyed if we don't do something on Deirdre's turn. But I have a plan, so we'll see how that works. All right, so we played all our cards. That's what happens. Now it is time to fight. Now Gurky can taunt, and I don't know if he wants to taunt. It's does he want... You know what? I think he's going to use the taunt. He's going to taunt away... what's he going to taunt away? I think he will taunt away the Razor Tooth Beast. So the Razor... He brings a Razor Tooth Beast over. It has 2 damage on it. Now let's see if we can destroy it. So he's going to use his Assassin to attack... Now let's do Deirdre's first. So she's going to use the soldier with the short sword attacking Razor Tooth Beast. That's going to put 2 damage on it. So it's going to go from 2 damage to 4 damage. Has a health of 8. Has no defense. And now we don't have any tanks or anything, so we can attack whichever one we want. And now the Assassin, which is going to be, wow, a yellow die +2, and he's going to attack the Razor Tooth Beast. So we're going to need, we're going to need to not roll a 1, would be good. And we roll a 2, which I think is just enough, because that's going to be 4 damage. It already has 4 damage. Wow, we just got rid of the Razor Tooth Beast. So that is excellent. Away it goes. So now it is time to get to the ending of the round. And the ending of the round is going to be... So he spent that already. Monsters. The active monsters deal damage. So he has the Hulking Monstrosity and the Giant Boar. That's going to be 2 damage. There's no shields. So Gurky is going to lose two of his 5 hit points. Down to 3. And then we have to attack the Red Dragon Inn. And unfortunately for us, the Red Dragon Inn only has 4 health left. It has Drog with 2 attacks, Giant Cobra 1. The Red Dragon Inn loses 3 hit points. So it cannot withstand another hit, I don't think. So we're going to have to do something here shortly. That's the monster's damage. Now it's the cleanup. So we resolve all cleanup abilities. We don't have any. Discard all played cards. Well, Gurky's going to discard the Assassin, and Deirdre is going to discard her soldier and the short sword. So that's that. And okay, so we've discarded all the cards, and now we discard any unused shield. We don't have any. So now it's recruit time. Gurky gets to recruit. Excellent. So let's go to the recruit area. He has 2 gold coins and a silver coin to spend. All right,
Gurky's got to make a decision here as to which...
He can basically afford anything because there's no gold. So he's going to spend his silver. So he'll spend 1 silver. Now he's to decide what he wants to get. I think he wants to get something red. Great Axe can taunt. The Mace can do 5 damage. The Tainted Blade... Reflect the Bard. Each player draws 2 cards, then discards a card. Or the Cooperative. Shield 1, draw a card. After fight, you may retire a card from your hand. I think he's going to get, just to have shields, he's going to get the Covert Operative because it gives us a shield and draw a card. So he's going to put that in his hand. That was his recruit. And we get another silver character showing up, the Berserker. A +4 if you have 5 hit points or fewer. Whoa, that could work for either of our characters right now. So that's pretty awesome. All right, that was recruiting. Now it is time to discard cards for the defending player. Well, he doesn't have any cards to discard. So let's go back and finish up. All right, so Gurky here, the only card he has in his hand, of course, is the one he just recruited, the Covert Operative. So that's going to remain in his hand. And now he gets to refill. So Gurky, of course, now we're second level. The Gurky second level is going to reset. So it's going to be available. And he's going to draw 4 cards. So I have to shuffle up. Sorry, I'm doing this sort of on camera. To shuffle up Gurky's draw deck. And he's going to draw 4 cards for a total of 5. So far, we haven't lost. So that's good. Now, if our... Red Dragon Inn is destroyed, each player loses 4 hit points. So if the Red Dragon Inn goes down in flame, we've obviously lost the game. And I think, did I just screw this up? I think I may have just screwed things up because of the taunt. Okay, so actually we're gonna retro. We're gonna put this cooperative guy back and he's gonna get the Collegium Elder instead because it has taunt. That was the plan. Sorry about that. So this guy's going back. I just thought of that now. If we don't do that, we will lose the game on Deirdre's turn. And hey, we don't want to do that, do we? All right, so sorry about the retroing that. But now he's going to draw 4 cards. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And he gets an Apprentice, Eagle Eye Sniper. That's a good one. Wand of Magic Missiles and an Acolyte. So this is what he has. Not bad. Not great, but not bad. All right. And that will conclude Gurky's turn, I believe, if I've done everything. Yep. So the marker now passes over to Deirdre. And she only has 2 hit points left. So things about to get interesting. All right, let's readjust the camera a bit here, and we'll do Deirdre's turn. I have to think about it first. All right, so I'm trying to figure out how to do this without taking maximum pain. I think Deirdre's going to... And again, we cannot have our location take any damage on Deirdre's turn, or we're going to lose the game. So she's going to immediately taunt, uses the taunt token, and she's going to bring Drog, the Troll General, down in front of her. So she's going to be having to battle him, which is going to be painful, I think, but that's what she has to do. Up next, we're going to have Gurky gets to play a character. He's going to play the Collegium Elder, which has taunt. So he plays that, and he's going to taunt the Cobra away from the location, and he's going to play the Wand of Magic Missiles on the Collegium Elder. Now, the good thing is, I do believe, that we now have gotten all the monsters away from the Red Dragon Inn. So we get the reward. It still had 1 hit point left. A player of the party's choice may recruit a card from the reinforcements for free. Okay, we get a card from the reinforcements for free. And I think we're going to have Deirdre recruit for free. So let's go up and we're going to have a look
and see which card she's going to recruit for free. All
right, and I think for her, the card that makes the most sense to recruit for free is the Talisman of Lightning. Because to roll a yellow die, she gets to add an extra hero, and it does splash 2. I think she's going to... she recruits that for free. Of course, it gets replaced with... All right, finally, a gold item. A green +4 Scepter of Majesty. That is excellent. Excellent, excellent. I hope, if we survive. All right, back to Deirdre. She now gets to play 2 heroes because the defending player gets +1.
Wow. Hero.
This is a tough game to beat. All right, so she gets to play 2 heroes. She's going to play herself, which means you get shield 1 and a player of your choice draws a card. So we get 1 shield. Now I have to decide which... player I want to draw a card. I think I'm going to have Gurky draw a card because I'm going to get to refill at the end of this turn. So Gurky draws an Acolyte. Well, that was a kind of useless card, but okay, that's what it is. So Deirdre's played 1 hero. She gets to play another hero if she wants, and she gets to play an item on each hero. So she's going to play the Talisman of Lightning on herself. And that allows her to add 1 more hero and splash 2, which means she can actually play both of these Acolytes. So she can play a total of 3 heroes because she just played a plus hero. So she's going to play the Acolyte with the Amulet of Protection, giving another shield. So we have a shield and we have dual wield. Well, we don't have any more items to basically dual wield, so that's not really going to happen. And we just play the last Acolyte as an Acolyte. Wow. Okay, we have... Or do I want to save that Acolyte to use the Scepter of Magistry? Oh, no, I'm not going to. Not going to. Oh, boy. Okay, that was everyone playing. Now it's time to attack. And unfortunately, Drog, the Troll General, is a tank. So we have to attack Drog. We don't have an option. So let's just start with Gurky. And yes, of course, my camera battery's dying. So... let me just change that. We'll come right back and we're going to be having to attack Drog the Troll General. Okay, fresh battery in and fresh time to beat on Drog. So we get to roll a yellow die and we're going to add +1 to it. So let's make some room here. For the yellow die, come on, a 4 and we get +1. So yes, we get a 4. +1 is 5 damage. He blocks 2 of it, but he's still going to take 3 damage. All right, 3, we only have to give him 22 more points of damage, and we'll take him out. Okay, well, at least that was a good roll. Okay, so, well, this Acolyte, this Acolyte attacks does nothing, because 1 damage is not enough. We're going to discard it anyway, so let's not worry about it. We do have this Acolyte acting, though, with the Amulet of Protection. So it's going to be another yellow +1. So come on, let's get another 4. Yellow +1. We get a 3 +1 is 4 damage. He's going to take 2 more hits. So now he has 5 damage of 25 hit points. Excuse me. And now Deirdre gets to roll 2 yellow die, or 2 yellow dice, for her attack against Drog. So come on, let's get 2 fours. 2 fours, come on! A 3 and a 2. Well, that's 5. He blocks 2. So he's going to take another 3 points of damage. So we've done a total of 6. We've done 8 damage to him. Unfortunately, he has 17 hit points left, which is a lot. All right, that is the end of all of our playing cards and attacking. Now it's monster damage. Well, Deirdre would take 2-3 damage. She has 2 shields, so she's only going to take 1 damage, and that's really all she can afford, because that puts her down to 1 hit point, which is, which could be game over. Now, we have slash 1, which means Gurky is also going to take 1 point of damage. He has 3 hit points. He's now down to 2. Ouch. But we survived. The location would take damage from monsters, but there's no monsters on the location because we've completed that. Now we're into the cleanup. Resolve all cleanup abilities.
discard all played cards. All right, so Gurky discards his cards, and Deirdre discards all of the cards she played. All right, and she's going to refresh herself, of course, this time, so I'm just going to put her character there again. And that was discarding all played cards. Any unused shield tokens? Yeah, like you'd ever have unused shield tokens. And now it's time to recruit. So Deirdre gets to recruit. And I don't think I'm going to adjust the camera because she's just going to spend one gold and she's going to recruit this totally awesome thing. Or is she? Oh, man. I don't think she can because she desperately... Oh, no, she gets a shield. Never mind, never mind. She is going to recruit the Scepter of Majesty. Excellent card to recruit. And the replacement card is just a Tainted Wand, which is semi-powerful, but... not really that useful at the moment. Okay, so that she's recruited. So that's excellent. And now she can discard any cards, not going to, and she gets to refill. So she gets four more cards. So one, two, three, four cards. Well, she's down to the bottom of her deck. And the four cards she gets are Freezing Staff, Soldier, Soldier, Elven Bow. Well, okay. Okay, we can... we can live with that, I guess. Well, like we have a choice. We're going to have to live with that. All right. And that then concludes Deirdre's turn. Now, I wonder how close we are to... Wow, I think we're pretty much at the point where we might as well call it an episode, which means the next episode may not be as long, but it's going to conclude one way or the other. Let me just readjust the camera, talk a little bit about next episode's strategy, and we're going to have to go from there. All right, so what we're going to do at the end of this episode, of course, the taunt marker is now going to pass over to Gurky, and unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, I don't know, Gurky now has the taunt token, because he's going to be the first player for our next episode. Unfortunately, Drog is going to come over now and be the active player against Gurky. So you know what? Maybe we're not going to have another episode because I don't believe we're going to be able to win this because Gurky only has two hit points left. He has one, two, three, four, five potential damage against him. We're just going to go ahead and we're going to play this last round because I don't think... there's anything that can be done. So, of course, Deirdre gets to play one character and one item. Yeah, we're just going to finish off the episode because I don't believe we could pull this off. So she's going to play Shield 1. A player of your choice draws a card. Well, there's no point her drawing a card. So she's going to have Gurky draw a card. Come on, something good. He draws the Assassin. Okay, all right. We'll now, we did get one shield. Because of her Deirdre playing her card. Now, Gurky gets to play two characters. He gets to play two. What does he want to play? Well, he's obviously going to play the Assassin. And does he want to play the Eagle Eye Archer? You can discard two cards. Well, no, he's going to play the Assassin. He gets to play another character, so he's going to play the Apprentice, which gives him draw a card. And he gets plus one hero. So he can have one more hero, I think. One more or two more? He gets two to start with. That would give him three. So he's played two heroes. He can play one more hero. I think he's going to have to play Eagle Eye Sniper, which is you may discard two cards from your hand to snipe eight. So he's going to discard his two apprentices to immediately get a snipe 8. And of course, snipe 8 means you can attack whomever you like. So he will attack Drog for 8 damage. That's going to put 6 more damage onto Drog. So that's pretty good. Unfortunately, I don't know how we're going to pull this off, but we're going to try it. All right, so that was the Eagle Eye Sniper. Well, he attacks for 0, so I'm just going to discard him early to get him out of the way. The Apprentice attacks for one, bounces off the shield. That does nothing. But our Assassin gets to attack at a yellow plus two. A yellow plus two. Come on! 3 plus 2 is 5. 3 more damage. on Drog. So he has 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 16. He has 17 damage, 8 more hit points left, and we would kill him. Yeah. All right, over to Deirdre. Deirdre's got the big guns this time. She's going to be rolling a yellow and a green and adding 4 to it. A yellow, a green, adding 4. Come on. 9 plus 4, 13 minus 2 is 12. Trog is dead. We have killed him. So he's out of the picture. We managed to kill him. Wow, that's pretty awesome. He had 25 hit points, but now he's toast. The unfortunate business, we have only... Oh no, we're so close to hanging in there. We're so close. And she doesn't have any ability to taunt away one of these guys, which I think just lost us the game. No, because we only have one shield. And there's really... nothing at all left that we can do. Oh, we were so close. I cannot believe this. But anyway, that's the way it is. I think we're done. Because now we're going to go into monster damage. 1, 2, 3 damage. Minus 1 shield is 2 damage. Gurky, unfortunately, only has 2 life left. Darn it. I thought we could somehow pull this off. But we didn't. So we lost. We did take down Drog, though, so that's awesome. We saved the Red Dragon Inn. However, we have a giant cobra, a giant boar, the hulking monstrosity, and the two-headed giant still kicking around to rampage through the town. Wow, so that was Red Dragon Inn, Battle for Greyport. Again, it's a cooperative deck-building game. I quite like it. I haven't beat it yet. This, I think, is my 4th try. We just... can't quite pull it off, and maybe it's just my strategy has not always been the best. I apologize for errors along the way. I tried my best not to mess stuff up. I hope through comments and some notes posted in the videos, things can get squared away. So I hope you enjoyed it. It's a kind of a cool little deck building game, and I think you can play from 2 to 5 players. So I don't believe it has the ability for 1. Because of the taunt mechanics. I think it's a 2 to 5. But you can play 2 hands solo if you want, which is pretty good. So once again, thanks so much for watching along all the way. Thanks so much for your comments and your subscriptions. I really appreciate it. And also thumbs up, likes, really appreciate it as well. I really like doing these videos. I hope you guys like them. And yep, once again, don't know what's going to be coming up next, but it will be a complete cardboard or dice game playthrough. So join me then, and we'll see you next time for another complete playthrough series.